Hey guys, Alex from Aussie Auto Electrics. We have finished this Jayco lithium upgrade. We've currently got 400 amp hours of lithium, 3000 inverter. We'll have a quick look. Batteries on the side. There's our Victron Multiplus 3000. We got fusing and circuit protection at the back, isolating switches for the solar. We have a 100/50 solar controller and a drive 40 amp DCDC, and then the factory Caravan electrics. So this system is pretty easy to control. So up in the control panel here, we've put a new Victron battery monitor. So this one here, you can scroll up and down, percentage, hours. We've got, this is the main ones you'll use, will be the voltage and the amps. So you can see real time amps going in when it's charging and amps coming out. And watts if you like to work in watts. Below we have the multi-control panel. So this controls this 3000 inverter up from the cupboard. So this is all integrated into the Caravan 240 system. So we flick this switch, couple of beeps, microwave's got power, and the aircon as well. So we can plug into all your regular power points. Everything will perform as if you were plugged into mains power, although you're just running off your battery bank. And up here we can see our wattage figures, so you can go around and have a look. Obviously the aircon is quite a hefty drain, but check your percentage, quite easy to monitor. You watch the percentage go down, look for a source of charging if it gets too low. But this particular one has 800 watts of solar on the roof. So yeah, they're gonna have pretty good replenishment power. We'll just see if this aircon kicks in a bit, and we'll get a wattage figure for you. So this particular aircon is normally about 1200 or so watts. These ones aren't too economical. This is the Ibis 3. Newer models are definitely a bit better, and they're soft start as well. So everything's all contained under the bed. We've also thrown in a Sirocco fan here for the customer. These are pretty handy. Pull that pin, comes down. You've got three speeds. And then also 3 hour intervals, so the fan will turn off by itself automatically if you're free camping, you want to go to sleep and then not consume any power. The Sirocco fans are definitely our go-to 12 volt fan, as they very very powerful but draw very little power as well. So we'll come back. Our aircon quite hasn't ramped up yet. We're still at only 170 watts, which will just be the fan running. So when that compressor kicks in, we'll see it go up over 1000 there. Another good feature with the multi-control is we can limit the current. So if you're plugged into a caravan park and you got your typical 15 amp source, or if you go and stay at someone's property or house and they've only got your typical house power, you can dial that back. And this particular unit is an inverter charger, so it has a 120 amp battery charger built in as well, which you can also dial back through that current limiter depending on what source you're plugged into. Let's give this aircon a sec, it's taking a while. Had it running before, so it's probably already a little bit cool. Jayco, couple of bunk beds in there, toilet shower in the back, nice setup van. These guys will be heading off and doing the lap. Percent. So if you can monitor your phone battery, you can easily monitor this system. It's literally just checking the percentages. You can see how much power you're using every day, and then forecast how long you can stay at places. With the solar controller as well, it's all Bluetooth compatible, so you can go back in the solar controller's history and see the power you've been harvesting. Righto, aircon's cut in. 1.2 kilowatts there. Let me scroll through. 94 amps. So yeah, like we said, these ones aren't very economical, but there is strategies to make your power last longer. But that's pretty much it. Nice and tidy, easy to use, and plug into pretty much any PowerPoint. Easy as.